Page 186, okay. All right, yeah. Thank you. Yeah, so the first thing we saw is the resolving limit of the eye. The eye cannot see things which form an angle. It cannot separate points which form an angle smaller than 1 minute. So 1 minute is the smallest angle that two points should be subtending on the eye for the eye to see those two points as separate. Isse zyada agar pass mein leke aoge, to it will look, they'll start to get distorted. They'll start to look as if they're overlapping. Then in this particular question, one of you is asking me, why did I multiply by pi by 180? So first of all, 1 minute is 1/60 degrees. You guys know that. But then look at what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to find this distance. I'm approximating that distance for a small angle by the arc length. And I'm trying to use this formula which says arc length is r times theta. This formula, why are we using this? You know, where did this formula come from? This formula came from the definition of angle in radians. Angle in radians is defined as arc length by radius. That means whenever we use this formula, the angle has to be in radians. Otherwise, it's just not right. It's just not going to work. So to use this formula, the angle must be in radians. Isliye we converted degrees into radians. Okay. Is this persistence of vision? But I think persistence of vision has to do with time. Like if you introduce frames, two separate frames in less than a smaller time interval, somebody saying 1/6, okay, then apparently you get to see those frames as a continuation of each other. So that has to do with persistence of vision. Wo time basis hai, ye thoda distance basis hai. Ek point se zyada inko pass mein leke aoge, to you'll not be able to see them as distinct. You'll not be able to see them as distinct. Okay. Now, it's like, why can't we read extremely tiny font? Because the spaces between any two lines is so small that it's subtending a smaller angle than one, subtending a smaller angle than 1 minute. That's why it looks as if they're all just one hazy dot. That's why we can't read really small font. Will optical instruments be finished today? Let's see. Let's see. As it is not a very big chapter, the formulas are just can all be summarized on one single page, but the derivation may take a little time. Yeah. Anyways, let's see. So near point for the human eye is at a distance of 25 centimeters. This is the least distance for clear vision. Okay. And class kab tak hai? Class 6 baje tak hai. Right? Wasn't that on your timetable? Just let me know. Is it till 6? Okay, it's till 6. Cool. Break, of course, milega. Break milega. Sumit, 1 minute. 1 minute, huh, Sumit. Let me just finish this off. The trees in this case, the Sumit, just hold on. The trees in this case seem to go behind with a velocity, both the tree and the mountain go behind with a velocity of 70 kilometers per hour. And given that thing, we ask, why does it seem like the tree is moving faster than the mountain? And what we discussed was that the length moved by the tree in the same time subtends a bigger angle. So the bigger the angle, the faster it's going to seem to move. Or the bigger the angle, the bigger the path it covers as seen by the eye. Okay. Sumit, S47. I don't think you're an authentic student. So Sorry, I'm going to remove you. Too bad. Cool. कुछ तो मैसेज कर रहा था सर अनम्यूट मी सर अनम्यूट मी एंड 20 बार मैसेज किया. Yeah, he was a spammer. All right, so let's move on from this. Now, the magnifying power of, based on this, let's see how the magnifying power of an optical instrument is defined. So this is the basic idea upon which we define magnifying power. See, magnifying power of any optical instrument is again represented by the same symbol M, and it's defined as angle subtended by the image on the eye, Image is something that is going to be formed by the optical instrument. So angle subtended by the image on the eye. Remember, size for us always has to do with angle. All right. So therefore, we are not comparing image sizes, but we are now comparing what angle they subtend on the eye. So angle subtended by the image on the eye divided by the maximum angle that the object can subtend on the eye. The maximum angle that the object can subtend on the eye in the absence of the instrument. So you need to now think, when would the object be subtending the maximum possible angle on the eye in the absence of the instrument? Kab wo sabse zyada angle subtend kar sakta hai? In short, we're just going to, when it is close, how close can it be for us to see it distinctly? How close can it be? There is a minimum distance, 25 centimeters, yes. So 25 centimeters ke distance pe when you place the object, that's when you'll have it subtending the max possible angle. So at this stage, I'm just going to define these two angles as beta and alpha. Yes, Sahil, we're going to define these and telescopes as well. We're going to define these two terms as beta and alpha. Just label these terms as beta and alpha. So, bar bar ye pura bada cheez likhne ka zarurat nahi hai. Alpha is this lower guy, beta is that upper guy. And the units of magnification is, it's typically written as x. So, fundamentally, it is unitless because it's angle upon angle, but it's represented as x. And x means times. So for instance, if beta is 2 alpha, then magnification will be 2x. Magnification is small m. You can use small m for it. Okay. So units kya, units bas x, 2x dekhne pe samajh mein aata na, double zoom, twice, it looks twice as big. So that's all it means. 2x means it looks twice as big as you can see. See, it's actually fundamentally it has no dimensions. Beta and alpha are both angle. So angle by angle cut ke, you have technically it's unitless, but you write x in front of it whenever you are talking about magnification. Now, just I hope you understood the definition. Angle in itself is also dimensionless. Yes, so angle by angle further, that also is basically dimensionless. So this just basically has to, x is just representing how much you're zooming in. And try to understand this definition. What are they saying? They're saying magnification is angle subtended by the image on the eye in this particular case in which we are using the microscope or the telescope divided by the max possible angle that the object can subtend on the eye without the instrument. So if your magnification is going to be less than one, this is of no use. Kyun? Fir instrument ka hi kaam nahi hai. If the above term is lesser than the below term, then the instrument was of no use. When will the instrument be of use? When you could max see till this angle, and instrument somehow creates an image which subtends an even greater angle on the eye, that's when the instrument is of use to us. That's when the instrument is actually helping us zoom in on the object. All right, so it makes sense to define magnification in this way. Now, based on this way, as you guys just said, the value of alpha was the denominator. Microscope will be one instrument, telescope will be another instrument that we are going to study in this chapter. So based on what we just saw, alpha, which is the maximum angle subtended by the eye, will be only some telescopes will be studied. Alpha, which is the maximum angle subtended by an object, this will take place when the object is placed at the near point. So is when the object is placed at the near point. See, this is going to make sense. The maximum possible angle an object can subtend is when it is placed at the near point. So imagine that this is our near point wala distance. Okay, least distance for clear vision. And let's say ki yahan pe edge distance dur, d distance dur, you place your object jiska height actually mein h hai, and your eye is over here, and this is subtending an angle. At this stage, the angle that is subtends is defined as alpha. The angle that it subtends is defined as alpha. Now, based on this, you may say ki tan alpha is h by d. But we are going to say that tan alpha is approximately equal to, let me just say tan alpha is exactly h by d. And I'm going to take tan alpha approximately equal to alpha. So therefore, alpha becomes h by d. Now, why am I doing this? Why do I know this angle is going to be small? Because think about the context in which you use this device. Don't you use a telescope or a microscope when you are looking at objects which subtend a small angle on the eye? Right? So the context in which we are going to use this will be for telescopes and microscopes, where anyways the objects look very close to each other and our eye cannot clearly see them. So we are studying this in cases where the angle is really small without the instrument when it lands on the eye. So alpha will be small. Alpha will be small in scenarios where telescopes and microscopes are used. Okay, so you can go ahead and just use alpha as h by d. So alpha will be small in scenarios where telescopes and microscopes are used. So what are you seeing? Okay. Let me just read. We have to calculate max angle from its. No. Okay. Let me just clarify this. You are going to calculate. See, let's say apna optical instrument. Let's just say optical instrument koi ek position mein in a particular position, it allows the object to subtend an angle of 10 minutes on the eye. Okay? And how does that make sense to us? How much is the optical instrument really magnifying the size of the object? So then you put the optical instrument aside, and without the instrument, what is the biggest angle that the object could subtend on your eye? Wo dekhlo. So without the optical instrument, let's say the object could subtend an angle of 2 minutes on the eye. When would it be doing that? What is the biggest angle it could subtend? We know the closer you subtend, the closer you place it, the bigger the angle it subtends. But we cannot see the object clearly if we place it closer than 25 centimeters. So we'll place it at a distance of 25 centimeters. और तब देखेंगे कि अरे इंस्ट्रूमेंट के बिना तो मुझे 2 मिनट का एंगल तक मिल रहा है. इंस्ट्रूमेंट से मुझे करंट पोजीशन में 10 मिनट का एंगल मिल रहा है इंस्ट्रूमेंट के कारण. सो यू विल कंपेयर द टू एंड देन यू विल से अरे मैग्निफिकेशन इज 5x 5 times. गॉट इट? सो अल्फा इज सिंपली एच बाई डी. डी इज 25 सेंटीमीटर्स. If h is given, you can find alpha. Alpha is simply h by d. Make sense? And I'll repeat why I said alpha is small. We are studying optical instruments. Specifically, we'll be studying telescopes and microscopes. So the scenario in which you use telescopes and microscopes is when the angle is small. And you use a microscope when you want to see a thing which is close by. You use a microscope and you want to see a thing which is close by, and it's so tiny that it's subtending a small angle on the eye. Similarly, in the case of telescopes, you see far off objects, but you're trying to distinguish between objects which are so far away that again they end up subtending a very tiny angle on the eye. So telescopes and microscopes wale cases mein, the kind of objects that you observe, either very small or really far away, in all those scenarios, if h is small or d is very big, alpha is bound to be small. Make sense? And one of you saying, how will we measure the angle? Just don't worry, man. You'll if filhal to h diya, d diya, to milega na angle. Alpha is approximated as h by d. D is 25. To object ka size bhi pata hai, to angle mil gaya. Got it? So I want you to understand what max angle is. Max, this is the max angle subtended on the eye without the instrument. Isse hum baaki sab compare kar rahe. D is the least distance, jo pichle class mein dekha, 25 centimeters se aur pass nahi place kar sakte hai. To 25 centimeters pe jab place karoge, tab jo angle dikhta hai. Uske comparison mein hum dekh rahe ki optical instrument iske comparison mein kitna bada angle deta hai. Got it? So this is our denominator. H by D is our denominator. In the formula for magnification, H by D is our denominator. We are comparing angle subtended by the image on the eye using the instrument with, read that again, max angle that the object can subtend in the absence of the instrument. So the max that it can subtend is when it is placed at the near point. Got that? With that definition, I think we can start looking at microscopes. So this is page 190. कोई पूछ रहा है 25 से आगे प्लेस किया तो बाबा ये डेफिनेशन है. हम जैसे हम ये कुछ देखने की कोशिश नहीं कर रहे कि what we are actually trying to, our focus is the microscope. So we want to see the angle subtended when the microscope is used in comparison to microscope ke bina kya angle subtend kiya ja sakta hai. Wo bhi max angle. So there is no reason for you to place it beyond D. If you place it beyond D, you're going to get a smaller angle. You will compare what the microscope is doing to the best thing you can do without the microscope. And the biggest size that you can get without the microscope corresponds to this angle when it is placed at the near point. Understood? So for alpha, you're strictly going to place it at the near point and nowhere else. Okay? All right. Now, so we're going to study microscopes. You all know what a microscope is. It's a device used to view nearby objects, small objects close to us. It's used to view small objects close to us. View small objects nearby. Yes, in the case of a microscope, your H is going to be very small. In the case of a microscope, your H is going to be very small. The first microscope we're going to study is a simple microscope. And the simple microscope is made up of a single lens. Any guesses what lens it should be? A simple microscope is also your magnifying glass. Yes. So as we saw already, the magnifying glass is a convex lens. It's a convex lens. Concave minimize karta hai, convex maximize karta hai. So, what's going to happen is, in the case of a magnifying glass, let's say this is my lens. Let's say my object is here. You'll use a convex converging lens, and you'll use a converging lens where you place the object ahead of the focus. You place the object ahead of the focus. So if you remember, when a real object is placed ahead of the focus, a virtual image is formed on the other side. And on the same side, in fact, a virtual image is formed on the same side. Yeah. And randomly, let's say, I'm going to draw this line, which helps us visualize the size of the image. So I'm going to draw this line. And let's say my image is formed over here. Image kidhar bhi ban sakta hai. By the time the object moves from F to the pole, image travels from minus infinity to the pole. So image could be on this side of F, that side of F, kuch bhi chalega. But let's just say the image is formed somewhere. See? And this is the size of the image. This is the size of the image. So if you remember, H was the size of our object. And let's just say H dash is the size of our image. Okay. Now, beta is the angle subtended by the image on the eye. Let's just see the definition of beta again. Beta is the angle subtended by the image on the eye. Now, you need to understand that we are going to use a magnifying glass in a situation where our eye is very close to the glass. So typically our eye is going to be somewhere over here. Okay? This may have not been the way you use a magnifying glass, but this is the way magnifying glasses are supposed to be used. Like you may perhaps have seen in cartoons and all, you might have seen detectives hold the glass close to their eye. Sherlock Holmes, you may see they hold the magnifying glass close to their eye. That's how it is supposed to be used. All right. So we are going to assume that our eye is right over there. See, this glass is very close to the eye. Now, because this is very close to the eye, Yeah, there will be, you will assume, negligible distance between the eye and the glass. You will assume negligible distance between the eye and the glass. Koi bol raha hai ki isko aage peeche move karta hai. That's maybe just to try and focus something. But otherwise, technically, it's very close to the eye. See, and you will assume ki there is no distance between the eye and the glass. So, beta was the angle subtended by the image on the eye. This is the image that is formed. Eye is seeing this virtual image. But instead of finding the angle subtended by the image on the eye, we will simply find the angle subtended by the image on the lens. Why? Because the lens and the eye are very close to each other. So for beta, simply take angle subtended by the image on the lens. Angle subtended by the image on the lens. Because the eye is close. Eye is very close. Now, based on this, according to our diagram, what becomes beta? If you see, image is subtending this angle on the lens. So this angle that you see over here, this angle becomes beta. Yes, I think my screen is lagging a little bit. But I hope it's not too much, I guess. Voice is also lagging. Okay, manageable, all right. Fine. So, one of you saying, sir, beta either alpha ke barabar dikh raha hai. Actually, nahi. What you are observing is, tu jo bol raha hai na, beta koi aur cheez ke barabar dikh raha hai. Actually, beta object jo angle subtend kar raha hai, uske barabar dikh raha hai. Please remember, this is not the definition of alpha. Hai na? Alpha ka definition ye tha ki lens hata do, object ko kuch aur distance, near point ke distance pe place karo, and then see the angle that is subtends. That is the definition of alpha. Got it? Right now, this is, you have a lens over here and your object ka distance is not D. Let's say your object ka distance is U naught. Let me unmute Parth. He's raising his hand.
So to find alpha, so we remove the lens and we put it at put the object at a distance of 25 centimeters, right?
Yes.
So can we just say alpha as tan inverse of height upon 25 centimeters?
Exactly. So, wo tan inverse hi hai. But fir tan inverse ko humne tan hata diya. Kyun? Because alpha is going to be small.
Got it. So it's just height upon alpha, right? Height upon 25 centimeters, right?
Just height upon 25.
Thank you.
And the next doubt is... Nahi, Ayush. Difference ye nahi aa raha tu sab baba beta is the same as this angle ek bar ye bata deta hu beta pata hai kitna hai beta is not h by d beta is just understand this look at this diagram what do you get to see tan beta is h by what isn't it h by object distance Tan beta is h by object distance. So there is a difference. I am not in this in a scenario in which I'm going to use my microscope. I need not place the object at a distance of 25 centimeters. I can place the object at a smaller distance. My only constraint is, just a minute, my only constraint is ki object ka distance f se kam hona chahiye. As long as object ka distance f se kam hai, this will work as a magnifying glass. Got it? Beta is different, alpha is different in this scenario as well. Because these angles are going to be small, we are going to say this is approximately equal to beta. So beta is h by u naught. Beta is h by u naught, alpha is h by d. Let me just unmute this guy again. Ha, Parth.
So sorry if I forgot to lower my hand, sorry.
Acha, theek hai. See, please just understand the difference. Alpha is edge by D, fixed. See, alpha is the biggest that the object can be seen to us when we place it at the near point. Ye fixed hai. Jo object ka size hai, uspe fix hoga. Alpha is edge by 25 centimeters. That cannot be modified. On the other hand, beta is edge by U naught. So the angle that the image is subtending on the eye is edge by U naught ultimately. It's the same as the object is subtending on the eye. In this scenario, object is not placed at a distance of D. Object can be placed anywhere within the focal length. And we have the ability to manipulate this. We have the ability to manipulate this. ठीक है, बस constraints इतना है कि image का distance d से ज्यादा होना चाहिए. ये समझ में आ रहा है? Image का distance d से ज्यादा होना चाहिए. I is seeing the image cannot be closer than d. I get to keep the object closer. I get to keep the object closer than the images, and therefore this serves as a magnifying glass. Yes. So what is our magnification based on this formula? What is our magnification based on this formula? M is beta by alpha. 1 minute, Ayush. M is beta by alpha. Beta is edge by object distance. Alpha is edge by D. So my magnification comes out to be D by U naught. So if I can keep the object at a distance closer than D, I can send the image at a distance beyond D. And my magnification accordingly will be greater than 1. See? Let me just unmute this guy.
So how is beta h by mu naught if it is the angle subtended by the image? And why are we considering object distance then?
So beta is, if you look at the diagram, fair enough, beta is... Take it to be the image distance. So let's say image distance is V naught. So can I say beta is edge dash by V naught? But look at the similar triangles that are formed. Beta is image ka size by V naught. And image ka size by V naught is the same as edge by U naught. So you could have taken beta like this as well. But the reason I picked this one is so that on the next page, while calculating magnification, h and h cancel out. That's why instead of h dash by v naught over here, we took it as h by u naught. All right? The magnification is d by u naught. Based on where you place the object, you'll have different levels of magnification. Got it? Yes, the D by U naught, D is 25 centimeters, 25 centimeters by U naught. D is 25 centimeters, so 25 centimeters by U naught. Yes, edge by D remains fixed for the object. D to fixed hai, D to fixed hi hai, and H ka size anyways, object ke size pe depend karta hai. So h by d is fixed for the object. This is what we can control. This is in our hands. We can use a magnifying glass such that u naught, that such that where I have to place the object is lesser than d. And when I place the object at a distance lesser than d and use that magnifying glass, I will end up getting magnification which can be greater than 1. Okay? Don't worry. Just keep asking till you get it. And then only then we'll proceed. Okay. Let's just think of the range of values of U naught. Yeah? So to make sense of this, इसको समझने के लिए वील नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड यस अल्फा बीटा यही है, मतलब मैग्निफिकेशन में ही यूज होता है, एंड अल्टीमेटली मैग्निफिकेशन इज द मेन थिंग दैट वी हैव. अब मुझे यू नॉट का थोड़ा और सेंस, आई नीड टू मेक मोर सेंस ऑफ दिस. ऑब्जेक्ट को किधर प्लेस कर सकते हैं, है ना? सो इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट, लेट्स सी वेयर इज द फर्दस्ट पॉइंट दैट यू कैन प्लेस यू नॉट. क्या लग रहा है डायग्राम के हिसाब से, यू नॉट ज्यादा से ज्यादा कितना दूर प्लेस कर सकते हो? एट एफ? नहीं 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 एट एफ. प्लीज एक चीज समझो. वन ऑफ यू सेइंग 25 सेंटीमीटर्स. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड वन थिंग कि ऑब्जेक्ट का डिस्टेंस हैज नथिंग टू डू विद डी राइट नाउ. आंक ऑब्जेक्ट को देख ही नहीं रहा है. आंक किसको देख रहा है? इमेज को देख रहा है. ये बंदा डी के आगे नहीं होना चाहिए, दैट वी अग्री. तभी ही आंक इमेज को क्लियरली देख पाएगा. ऑब्जेक्ट का क्या कंस्ट्रेंट है? ऑब्जेक्ट शुड बी लाइंग विद इन द फोकस. सो ऑब्जेक्ट का डिस्टेंस कैन नॉट बी ग्रेटर देन एफ. ऑब्जेक्ट का डिस्टेंस कैन नॉट बी ग्रेटर देन एफ. ऑब्जेक्ट का डिस्टेंस कैन नॉट बी ग्रेटर देन एफ. कैन वी नोट दैट? ठीक है, जस्ट नोट की यू नॉट. I'll note this here itself. U naught cannot be greater than F. So U naught has to be less than equal to F. And image, because jab agar U F ke beyond hai, to fir wo virtual image banega hi nahi. Real image banega dusri taraf. Eyes cannot see real images, right? So U naught has to be less than equal to F. And image ka location, ye jo V naught hai na, that has to be greater than equal to d. image ya to d ya d ke beyond banna chahiye. ab samajh mein aa raha hai? u not f ya f ke aage place kar sakte ho, aur image d, by d I always mean 25 centimeters, image d ya d ke beyond banna chahiye, tabhi hi ank image ko clearly dekh payega. got that? okay. So based on that idea, F is in your hands. You can use a magnifying glass where F is smaller than D. See, and typically that is what will be used. So look at the minimum magnifying power. Minimum magnifying power. Minimum M will be when you have maximum U, where the object is placed as far as possible. So minimum M ke liye maximum U naught. Minimum M ke liye maximum U naught. Moreover, when we... Ek second. When I place at the minimum M, and when I get my object distance at as... keep my object distance as large as possible, that simply is another way of saying, where am I placing my object? I'm placing my object at the focus. When I place my object at the focus, let's use F for focal length. So when I place my object at the focus, small f for focal length, then my image will be formed where? Image is formed at me. ऑब्जेक्ट को फोकस पे डालोगे तो इमेज कहां पे बनेगा? इमेज इज फॉर्म्ड एट इंफिनिटी. देयरफॉर दिस इज व्हेन द आई इज लीस्ट स्ट्रेन्ड. व्हेन इज द आई मोस्ट स्ट्रेन्ड? When is the eye most strained? When the image is at D. Very nice. So eye is the most strained when you place the image as close as possible. Hai na? But the eye is the least strained when the image is formed far. It's formed far and big. Eye is the least strained. Hai na? That's why you don't have any problem looking at the stars. You can look at the sky. It's far away. There's no strain on your eyes. But if you look at something which is very close to your eyes are strained. So these are all alternate titles. This title is also called as normal adjustment. Yeah, this is also called as normal adjustment. So I'm giving you alternate ways of referring to this situation that a question may use. Again, so this situation called as the normal adjustment, called as a normal adjustment, is the situation where your eye is least strained. This is also the situation where you are getting minimum magnification from the instrument. And this is also the situation where your object is at the focus, your image is at infinity. Your object is at the focus, your image is at infinity. Is condition mein tumhara magnification kitna hota hai? So V naught is equal to infinity. U naught is equal to F. And therefore, your magnification in this situation comes out to be D by U naught, but D by U naught is D by F because U naught is F. So magnification, minimum magnification when you use a simple microscope can be D by F, and D by F is in your hands. You can keep a small focal length. You can keep a focal length lesser than 25 centimeters. 12.5 centimeters ka focal length agar use karoge to minimum 2x ka magnification aayega, minimum 2x zoom aayega. Got it? Okay, now I'll just address your doubts. Let me know if you have any doubt on this page. Previous page dekhna tha, to dekh lo. Ha, M is in your hands. Yes. M, minimum magnification is D by F. Jitna kam focal length loge, utna acha tumhara magnification. One of you, so Ayush had this doubt. I'll just mention this for the last time. You're mentioning something about the eye forming real images. You're mentioning something about the eye forming real images. So just please understand one thing that has to do with the mechanism of the eye, which is not what we are concerned with. Ye alag baat hai ki jab aank koi bhi cheez ko dekh raha hai, तब वो अल्टीमेटली ये डाइवर्जिंग रेस को कन्वर्ज कराता है. कन्वर्ज कराने के बाद कुछ तो रियल इमेज बनाता है एट द बैक ऑफ द रेटिना एंड योर ऑप्टिकल नर्व्स रेक्टिफाई दैट इमेज. टिपिकली इफ यू हैव एन ऑब्जेक्ट लाइक दिस, एक इन्वर्टेड इमेज बनेगा, योर ब्रेन प्रोसेसेस दैट, रेक्टिफाइज दैट, ऑल ऑफ दैट. दैट इज नॉट आवर कंसर्न एक्चुअली. व्हाट आवर फोकस इज दिस पार्ट. If you see this part, you will realize that your eye makes sense of diverging rays. So for it to make sense of diverging rays, it needs a virtual image. Kyunki virtual image is one where the rays appear to diverge after passing through the lens. इसका एग्जांपल लो. हाँ ले, यूज़ अ नॉर्मल मिरर, है ना. हाउ डू वी सी आवर रिफ्लेक्शन इन द मिरर? आफ्टर द रेज बाउंस ऑफ द लेंस दे अपीयर टू डाइवर्ज, एंड व्हेन योर आई नाउ सीज दिस, देन इट अंडरस्टैंड्स कि अरे दीज रेज आर कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट ओवर देयर, एंड देयरफॉर इट इज एबल टू सी द वर्चुअल इमेज ऑफ दिस रियल ऑब्जेक्ट. सो योर आई कैन ओनली सी वर्चुअल इमेजेस. दिस इज द पार्ट वी आर कंसर्न्ड विद इन ऑप्टिक्स. We are not going into the mechanism, what happens beyond the lens of the eye. But while reaching the lens of the eye, the rays should be diverging. The rays should appear as if they're coming from some point. Only then the eye can see that point or make sense of that point. Correct? So that's why we say ki your eye can see virtual images, not real images. Okay. So minimum magnification is D by F. ठीक है, एफ विल बी गिवन टू अस. कोई पूछ रहा है सर यू नॉट दे देंगे क्या, अरे दे सकते हैं, कुछ कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. सवाल बनाने वाले को एज इट इज ये मेंस का टॉपिक है, तो दिस इज इसपे क्वेश्चंस आर एकदम डायरेक्ट फॉर्मुला बेस्ड. एट द एंड यू जस्ट नीड द फॉर्मुलाज, विच इज ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड वेयर दिस कम्स फ्रॉम, सो दैट दैट स्टे इन योर हेड, बट अदरवाइज इट्स जस्ट फॉर्मुला बेस्ड. सवाल इस पे अगर सवाल बनाना है तो यू नॉट दे देगा, बोलेगा कि एक मैग्नीफाइंग ग्लास इज यूज वेयर द ऑब्जेक्ट का डिस्टेंस इज 10 सेंटीमीटर्स, निकालो मैग्निफिकेशन. तो करोगे 25/10, 2.5x. दूसरे सिनारियो में यू नॉट नहीं दे देंगे, फोकल लेंथ ऑफ द लेंस दे देंगे, बोलेंगे कि फोकल लेंथ ऑफ द लेंस था 12.5 सेंटीमीटर्स, है ना. तो तब मैग्निफिकेशन, मिनिमम मैग्निफिकेशन कितना होगा, तो मिनिमम होगा 25/12.5, 2x. One of you is asking, is it necessary to put x? डाल देते हैं यार, zoom में हमेशा डाल देते हैं, डाल दो, looks cool, put that x in the end. Anyways, तुम्हें option pick करना है, वो खुद डाल के देगा तुम्हें, बस pick करना होगा option exam में. Now, what about the maximum magnification? फिर ऐसा तो बंदा सोच सकता है कि अगर object का distance f से कम है, why not put the object at zero? अगर object का distance f से कम है, if that was the only constraint, why not place the object at a distance just in front of the lens? Why not place the object at zero distance? What is the problem if the object is very close to the lens? Image will always be formed as long as the object is here. Image is always formed. Object ko lens ka thoda aage place kar lo. Come on, V ka problem hai. Yes, jab object ko idhar place karoge, there is no problem in how big the angle is of the image. Angle to kafi bada hoga, that's good. But the problem is your image is also formed that close. ऑब्जेक्ट को पास लेके जाओ, इमेज भी पास आते जाएगा. ऑब्जेक्ट को ऑलमोस्ट जीरो डिस्टेंस पे प्लेस करो, इमेज भी ऑलमोस्ट जीरो डिस्टेंस पे आएगा. एंड दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज योर आई कैन ओनली सी इमेजेस व्हेन देयर डिस्टेंस इज ग्रेटर देन डी. सो देयरफॉर दैट्स आवर प्रॉब्लम. आई कांट कीप ब्रिंगिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट क्लोजर एंड क्लोजर बिकॉज बियॉन्ड अ सर्टेन डिस्टेंस, इफ आई ब्रिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट टू क्लोज, इमेज का डिस्टेंस डी से कम होगा, और जब इमेज का डिस्टेंस डी से कम होगा, वी विल नॉट बी एबल टू सी द इमेज क्लियरली. ऑलराइट, सो देयरफॉर ऑब्जेक्ट का डिस्टेंस, एक ऐसा पॉइंट आएगा जब इमेज इज फॉर्मड एट द नियर पॉइंट. सो लेट मी टॉक अबाउट दैट सेकेंड केस. सो मैक्सिमम मैग्निफाइंग पावर या मैक्सिमम एम कब बनेगा, व्हेन द इमेज इज एज क्लोज एज पॉसिबल. सो मैक्सिमम एम रिक्वायर्स मिनिमम यू नॉट. मिनिमम यू नॉट के साथ साथ क्या होता है, मिनिमम वी नॉट, है ना. अब वी नॉट कम से कम कितना हो सकता है, डी हो सकता है. द इमेज कैन नॉट बी फॉर्म्ड एनी क्लोजर देन द नियर पॉइंट. तो वी नॉट सबसे कम डी हो सकता है. व्हेन इट इज एट डी, then our image is of course formed at the near point, and in that situation our eye is the most strained, hai na. Jitna close leke jaoge to utna strained your eyes will be. So in this situation your eye is the most strained, theek hai. Your eye muscles are just able to change the focal length of your eye ka lens and just able to form the image clearly on your retina. Isse zyada pass mein leke aoge to your eye will not be able to form a clear image on the retina. So in this condition the eye is the most strained. We are using minimum value possible of V naught. Remember V naught could never be lesser than D. V naught could be anything greater than D, lesser than infinity, hai na. So V naught could not be lesser than D. So when V naught is the least, U naught is also the least. and we try to figure out u naught ka value kya hoga for this magnification. But let's try to solve that. V naught is at D. Image is formed at the near point. Apply your lens formula now. By the way, all this while, these are just distances. Ab tak main coordinates use nahi kar raha hu. I was just talking about distance. U naught is also just a distance. They are not coordinates. But when I apply my lens formula, tab proper sign convention ke hisab se dal denge. Hai na? To mera image, thoda dhyan se dekhna padega. ऑब्जेक्ट किधर है, इमेज किधर है. तो ऑब्जेक्ट यू नॉट डिस्टेंस पे है और अपना इमेज डी डिस्टेंस पे है. सो ऑब्जेक्ट का डिस्टेंस इज यू नॉट, डिस्टेंस इज यू नॉट, इमेज का डिस्टेंस इज डी. सो व्हेन आई प्लेस इट विद द साइन कन्वेंशन इन आर फॉर्मूला, वी बिकम्स द कोऑर्डिनेट बिकम्स नेगेटिव डी एंड सिमिलरली द कोऑर्डिनेट ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑल्सो बिकम्स नेगेटिव यू नॉट. Negative u naught and focal length f becomes equal to your focal length because focal length is positive, f ka coordinates is also positive. Yahan se dekho ki u naught ka kya value aa raha hai, distance ka kya value aa raha hai, to kitna aa raha hai ye 1 by minus d ko udhar leke jao to wo positive ho jayega and ye ho jayega 1 upon u naught, hai na, ye positive already hai. To 1 by u naught is 1 by d plus 1 by f. Because LCM lelo, you'll get D plus F by FD. D plus F by FD. So, yahan se we get ki U naught is equal to FD by D plus F. This was in fact the minimum value of U naught. This was the minimum value of U naught. क्योंकि u नॉट के ये वैल्यू पे इमेज नियर पॉइंट पे बनता है. इससे कम ऑब्जेक्ट डिस्टेंस प्लेस करोगे, इमेज नियर पॉइंट के आगे बनेगा, आंख उसको देख नहीं पाएगा. तो कम से कम इतना डिस्टेंस होना चाहिए. ओके, सो बेस्ड ऑन दिस आर मैक्स मैग्निफिकेशन, आर मैक्स मैग्निफिकेशन, ठीक है, इन दिस सिनेरियो व्हिच वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट बाय द सिंबल MD. D is when your image is formed at near point. So our max magnification kitna aata hai? Let's apply that formula that we saw. Hai na? Formula kya tha? D by U naught. To likh ke dekho, D by U naught. So it seems to be D upon DF divided by D plus F. DD katega. And you get an interesting result. Yes, you get D plus F by F. And D plus F by F is actually D plus F, sorry, D by F plus 1. Very nice. So this is D by F plus 1. And why is that interesting? Because this is the previous answer plus 1. Yeah, the max magnification is actually minimum magnification plus 1. MD is D by F plus 1. Ab aa gaya, matlab coincidence bol sakte ho. Ha, coincidence, in a way coincidence hi ho raha hai. Ye calculation ke through aa raha hai, but that's just easy to, that makes it easy to remember ki magnification aisa aa raha hai, M infinity plus 1. So your max magnification is your minimum magnification plus 1. Okay. So over here, I'll just add in key, the way your image was, sorry, yeah, there's also a D in the denominator ko upar laya na. So D plus F by F ho gaya wo. DD कट गया, एक D एक D कट गया एंड D प्लस F by F हो गया, F by F को 1 लिख लिया. आई वुड सजेस्ट लर्न दिस, अभी ये मेन्स का एग्जाम में आएगा ना, सो आई वुड से यू मेमोराइज दिस. इट विल बी गुड टू थोड़ा मतलब डेरिवेशन का आइडिया रख लो, बट अंत में मेमोराइज कर लो बिकॉज मेन्स के एग्जाम में योर टाइम कंस्ट्रेंट, टाइम इज अ कंस्ट्रेंट, तो यू कांट रियली स्पेंड टाइम डिराइविंग एवरीथिंग. बट इट फ्रॉम एन अंडरस्टैंडिंग पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू डेरिवेशन इज गुड. What does M infinity and MD stand for? So just to revise that, what do they stand for? Your magnification for a simple microscope lies between two values, lies between D upon F and 1 plus D upon F. D upon F is your minimum magnification, and your minimum magnification occurs when your image is formed at infinity. Remember, infinity means least strained. This is also called, V naught is maximum in this case. Okay? In this, your eye is least strained. This is also called as your normal adjustment. 1 plus D by F, which is your max magnification, that occurs in a situation where your image is formed at the near point. So M and D, ये जो सबस्क्रिप्ट है विच दीज गाइज फॉलो दैट दैट डील्स विद वेयर द इमेज इज फॉर्म्ड. तो एक कंडीशन में इमेज इंफिनिटी पे बन रहा है, एक कंडीशन में इमेज नियर पॉइंट पे बन रहा है. नियर पॉइंट वाला विल बी मोस्ट स्ट्रेन्ड. नियर पॉइंट वाला विल बी मोस्ट स्ट्रेन्ड. गॉट इट? एंड क्वाइट सिंपली इन दिस केस yes, your image is in this way going from infinity to D, and during that process your object is going from the focus to going from the focus to kya tha yaar D DF by D plus F. I think with that summary, I hope you understood this. Normal arrangement is only this one. कोई पूछ रहा है कि are both called normal arrangement? नहीं, इसलिए नाम याद करना है. Normal arrangement is this guy. This arrangement is the normal arrangement. ठीक है? This is the normal arrangement. Minimum jabang jab eye is least strained when the image is formed at infinity, that's your normal arrangement. Got it? So I mean this mains ke level ke hisab se kaise sawal aa sakta hai isme. You can say a magnifying glass with F equal to five centimeters is used find the range of magnification possible. Okay, simple. And where should the object be placed? Where should an object be placed? Yes, Ayush, nice. Iske pehle bhi who answered, you're right. Where should an object be placed for 5.5x zoom, your 5.5x magnification? You can leave the answer as a fraction. Oops. Yes, Sairam, that's right. Satya, Ayush, Shreya, that's all right. Say it. Second Malika, you can leave it as a fraction. Sahil, you got the lower limit. Yes, Sanika, that's right. Yes, Rudra, that's right. Both simple, ekhi equation hai. You're right. Okay, so simple. Okay? The range is, yes, Aman, that's also right. The range of magnification is between D by F and 1 by D by F. So, bas wo nikalna tha. D by F and 1 plus D by F. So, bas D by F nikal do, dusra wala bhi aa jayega. So, D by F is 25 by 5. So, D by F is 5. So, that means 5x and 6x. One more than that. 5x and 6x ke beech mein, your magnification lies. See? And as for your second answer, where should an object be placed? So magnification in general is D by U naught. And of course, when you don't place it at those exact extreme value points, you'll get some other magnification between 5 and 6. So if 5.5 ka magnification chahiye, then just place it at such a place such that D by U naught is 5.5. So wahan se, of course, U naught becomes 25 by 5.5. Simple. Are. See? Isme, got it? Simple. Can I move on? After division, you get as 4.5. Theek hai na, that's fine. Kya problem hai? Matlab aa jayega 525 by 5.5 kuch aayega. Sorry guys, my net, I'm just trying to reconnect to it. Can you hear me now? Any chance? Okay. My screen is still frozen. Fix ho raha hai. Acha, samajh mein aa gaya na? Any doubt in this? All clear. U naught is 4.5 approximately. Fair enough. Okay. So that was a simple microscope section. Just some closing notes on the simple microscope. Don't worry, I wasn't sharing my screen. Just refreshing. Page. देखो लास्ट पेज देख लो. हाँ यू वी आई गिव यू अ ब्रेक एट 4:45 ठीक है. सो जस्ट सम क्लोजिंग पॉइंट्स. इसमें नोट अ कपल ऑफ थिंग्स. नोट दैट द इमेज इज अपराइट. नोट दैट द इमेज इज अपराइट है ना. यू रिमेंबर सीइंग इट इन द फर्स्ट डायग्राम इटसेल्फ. ऑब्जेक्ट भी अपराइट था, इमेज भी अपराइट ही था. सो नोट दैट द इमेज इज अपराइट. दैट्स वन थिंग टू नोट कि सिंपल माइक्रोस्कोप में अपराइट इमेज बनता है. एंड देन अनदर पॉइंट इज यू मस्ट रियलाइज दैट वी कैन कीप इंक्रीजिंग एम. एम कैन बी इंक्रीज्ड बाय डिक्रीजिंग एफ. बट देन बियॉन्ड अ सर्टेन पॉइंट यू स्टार्ट टू फेस सर्टेन प्रॉब्लम्स. सो एम कैन बी इंक्रीज्ड by making by decreasing f. Okay, it can be increased by decreasing f. However, if f becomes too small, if f becomes too small, if f becomes too small, aberrations become too large. So aberrations are some problems that you face. See? Aberrations are some problems that you face in forming the image forming a clear image. You can briefly read the last part of geometrical optics from your HCV. It's not really in your syllabus, but last part of geometrical optics in your HCV mentions different kind of aberrations, which you can just read for your information. It'll give you some insight into what happens when the focal length is too small. If you remember, all our lens formula was derived under the assumption that light is able to strike it at a small angle, that there is near normal viewing. Hai na? But if your focal length itself starts to become very small, focal length depends on radius of curvature. So if your focal length becomes very small, then the chances are that when light is striking the surface, that angle may not be very small. The angle it makes with the normal may still not be very small. So based on that, some of our assumptions go haywire. And as a result of that, your object, which may be straight, uska image ek alag shape ka banega. And then with the case of a lens, there is also the factor of different colors having different refractive indices. So then you start to have chromatic aberrations as well. And all of this can be negligible if our focal length is decently big. But if our focal length keeps becoming too small, then we are going to face problems. So you can, I'm just speaking very loosely. I don't want to spend too much time on this. can just briefly read the ending of geometrical optics from your HCV, which talks about aberrations. This is either way not in your syllabus. You can just read for your information if you're interested. Otherwise, just leave it. Just believe ki F se kam nahi ho sakta. So read ending of ray optics, geometrical optics from HCV. This is, by the way, not in your syllabus. And for your information, because of this reason ki hum F ko aur chota chota karte nahi ja sakte, because of these kind of reasons, you'll find that your magnification is typically less than 4x. Typically. Again, this is not something to remember. This is, again, just for your information. Yeah. This is for your information. Just to give you an idea why we would need something more specialized than a simple microscope. Simple microscope ka limitation hai. Jo tumhe ye formula dekhne pe lagega nahi. D by F dekh ke hai na, some bright minds mein think, aray F ko bahut chota kar do, infinite magnify kar lenge. Yeah, there are certain problems that you face when F starts to become very small. You can briefly read about these aberrations, spherical aberrations, chromatic aberrations. You can read about them from your HCV just to get some idea as to what they mean. And because of these limitations, your magnification normally cannot go beyond 4x, typically. All right, FYI, for your information. Just for your information. This is not a value you have to memorize or anything. Just for your information, you cannot cross 4x ka magnification using a simple microscope. So for higher magnification, we need to start using something called as a compound microscope, which uses an additional lens. Got it? FYI, everyone knows na kya hai wala. Electron microscope, again, something even more advanced, not in your syllabus at all. And again, not something purely on optics. So the next microscope that we have is compound microscope. My goodness, yaar, ye kabhi use nahi kiya gaya life mein. Just for your information. Cool. So let's just take a small break. Just we'll come back in 10 minutes. Come back by 4:58. Not 5:58, 4:58. And we'll move on to compound microscope. And koi pooch raha hai ki how long? Ye kuch nahi yaar. Ye compound microscope hone ka, maybe one more lecture mein telescope wagera kar lenge. One of you is saying 15 minutes, but your own classmate is saying, sir, only one lecture today, no need for a big break. So it's not me, it's because of your classmate that let's just keep it to 10 minutes. Come back by 5. Okay. Welcome. Bye. Hey, guys, don't leave the meeting. Huh? Just leave your phones the way it is and go. Yeah. All right, cool. Hope everyone's back. All right, so now let's look at a compound microscope. Some are in the waiting room. Okay. All right, so those just joining in, don't worry, you didn't miss anything. We're just starting. All right, so the next one is compound microscope. Okay, now, so in this, let's just see what the diagram looks like. And I would just say that be patient through the entire derivation. And once we're done with the derivation, it'll start to make sense key why we are doing whatever we are doing. All right. Now, one of you is asking HCV mein. Yeah, HCV ka jo last section hai na, which deals with defects in vision, aberrations and all that. They are not in your syllabus. Neither your advanced nor your main syllabus is going to ask that. You can read it for fun if you want, but it's not in your syllabus. Okay. Ray optics, whatever was in the syllabus has been completed. Okay? This is a separate chapter, separate topic, limited to mains. And again, whatever's in the syllabus, we'll be covering over here. So you have a compound microscope. Now, in a compound microscope, you typically will see two lenses. You're going to see one lens over here called the eyepiece. Okay? And I would just say, just be patient with the entire derivation. Most probably only in the end will it start to make complete sense. Okay? But of course, just make sure you're understanding the steps involved. But at the end of the derivation, you'll understand why we are doing whatever we're doing. So let's say this is your eyepiece and you have another lens over here called your objective. Okay? And the names are quite simple. Eyepiece is the lens jiske bagal mein you will place your eye. So it's the lens close to your eye, and objective is the lens close to your object. So your object is going to be placed somewhere over here. Now, I'm going to use the symbols O for the objective and E for the eyepiece. So when I say FO is over here, when I say FO is over here, I mean the focal length of the objective is over here. What we're going to do now is we are going to take our object and we're going to place our object at some distance, at a distance very close to F0, but slightly beyond F0. So our object, maybe I'll zoom in for this part. Okay, so our object is placed somewhere over here at the object height is H and its distance is slightly beyond F0. So place close to F0, but beyond F0. This distance is going to be U0. This distance is going to be U0. Why U0? This is U is for object. And let's say O is for the objective. Okay? So U ka distance from the objective is U0. Okay? And this is of course my... This is, of course, my object. Okay? I think I'll need to just relaunch that app. 1 minute. This is, of course, a real object. We are placing this in front of our lens. What is going to happen as a result of this is, this object, let me draw that again. this real object that we are placing close to the lens, placed close to the focus, but beyond it. Okay, FO is focus of the objective, O for objective. Okay, FO is focus of the objective. So it's going to be placed close to the focus of the objective, but slightly beyond it, slightly beyond it. Okay. And what's going to happen in this case is, it's going to form an image far, far away. Right? Because, jitna tumhara, what do you say? Jitna tum object ko f object ko exactly f naught pe place karte the, image technically infinity pe banta tha, hai na? Yahan pe we want the image to be formed somewhere over here, so object is slightly beyond u naught, and we are going to have a real inverted image formed, let's say roughly somewhere over here. Okay, we want the image to be formed somewhere behind this lens, but between the objective and the eyepiece. Okay. And it'll start to make sense soon. But let's just say, filal, my temporary image is formed over here. This is the image after passing through the objective. Okay. Ye image ka distance from the objective is, let's say, VO. Ab VQ, V because image. Aur kiska image? Objective ka image. And yes, this will be magnified. Kyunki image zyada dur ban raha hai. So this is going to be magnified. And how do I come to know that? I can just simply draw this line. So I'm going to draw this line passing through the center, which tells me ki a magnified image is formed. And let's say the height of this image is H dash. This image now serves as an object for the eyepiece. And this point forward, the story is the same as you would have for a simple microscope. So what is the story? Your simple microscope ka, let's say, tab maine u naught liya tha, ab ye distance ko ue lenge. Uq, because it behaves as an object for the eyepiece, and eq, because it is for the eyepiece. So this guy now behaves as an object for the eyepiece. Aur yaha se jab light jayega, by the way, the way this image is going to be formed is we are going to ensure that this time this image lies within the focal length of the eyepiece. Yes, so our image must lie within the focal length of the eyepiece. Our image must lie within the focal length of the eyepiece. So somewhere over here, within the focal length of the eyepiece, this time our I dash is formed. I dash behaves as an object for the eyepiece. And because I dash is ahead of the focus, we know a virtual image is going to be formed somewhere behind. A magnified virtual image is going to be formed. Let's say that virtual image is formed at this point. Okay? Let's say that virtual image is formed at this point. So this is where the final image is formed, I. Okay. And what is the height of the image going to be? To understand that, we need to draw this ray passing through its center, extend it back. And as you extend it back, you'll realize here iska height is H double dash. And it's a magnified final image that lands on the eye of the observer. And if you can see in this case, both the lenses were magnifying the image. Both the lenses were magnifying the image. At this stage, this guy, I dash is real. If you can see, I dash, ye jo I dash ban gaya, wo real ban gaya. Hai na? It was formed on this side of the lens. So I dash was real. But I is virtual. So the final image landing on the eye is virtual. Final image landing on the eye is virtual. See? One of you is saying I must lie beyond the objective. Aisa nahi hai. you're just saying this must lie beyond the objective. That's not necessary. Okay? This is still a magnified image, and let's just see how it is. One of you is asking, will the eye be able to see edge dash? No, unless you can stick your head between, inside the microscope, between these two lenses. If you plan to put your head there, then you can see edge dash. Even then you can't see edge dash because the edge dash is real. That'll be disappointing. But obviously your eye is seeing the final image. Jo dono lens ke through pass hoke aata hai, final image. So your eye is seeing this guy, and this is a virtual image. Therefore, your eye is able to see it. Any other doubt in the diagram? Let me see. What if UO is before? What if UO is before F? Phir to use hi nahi karenge. Compound microscope is not used in the situation where your object is placed ahead of F naught. I think it's not used in that situation. मिटाने नहीं दे रहा है एक मिनट ठीक है इन दैट सिचुएशन तो समझ सकते हैं ना एक रियल इमेज उधर पीछे बनेगा फिर कुछ पॉइंट ही नहीं है हाउ इज आई वर्चुअल सो थोड़ा तुम्हें रिवाइज करना पड़ेगा रियल वर्चुअल का गाइस फॉर अ लेंस इफ आई हैव एन ऑब्जेक्ट ओवर हियर ठीक है प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड फॉर अ लेंस वॉट एवर इट मे बी माई फाइनल रेज आर ऑन दैट साइड So because my final rays are on that side, any image formed on the other side is always real. There are no final rays here, so any image formed on this side is always virtual. So I dash is real because it was formed on the fine on the other side of the lens. But I is virtual because it's formed on the same side of the lens. That's cool. Yeah, that's okay. Cool. Now let's just continue. Yahan pe, just remember a couple of things. You'll normally see ki your eyepiece. Has bigger focal length. Eyepiece has bigger focal length. Eyepiece has bigger focal length and bigger aperture. Than the objective. Bigger focal length and bigger aperture than the objective. See? And that's just to ensure ki this eye dash, which is formed, that lies within the focal length of the eyepiece. Now, finally, virtual image banana hai, so that eye dash should be formed within the focal length of the eyepiece. Therefore, typically the eyepiece is given a bigger focal length, and with a bigger focal length, the size of the lens also gets bigger. So it's given a bigger aperture as well. Aperture would refer to the size of that disc. Samne se dekhoge to disc ka radius kaisa dikhega, that refers to your aperture. Okay, now type of questions that will come. So we'll need to derive the magnification now. So magnification, dekho, acche se samjho what is really going on. First and foremost, final image subtended, final angle subtended on the eye. The final angle subtended on the eye is going to be this angle beta. The final angle subtended on the eye is going to be this angle beta. And one thing I want you to observe in this case is beta is negative. Beta is negative. Because your image formed is inverted. Hai na? Alpha to upright tha. alpha was when your object was upright. You know, your object is upright, but in this case, beta is negative because the angle is below the axis. And because the angle is below the axis, this is also giving us an inverted image. And therefore, magnification technically negative aane wala hai. And we are going to keep beta this way because this makes sense. Magnification negative aa raha hai, matlab hume samajh mein aa raha hai ki inverted image ban raha hai. So we're going to take beta as negative because it's below the axis. And we'll just remind ourselves ki an inverted image is formed. Inverted image is formed. Okay. Moreover, let's try to figure out the value of beta. So from this equation, beta seems to be, let me label one more thing. Let me label, we'll just move this guy a little bit. Let's label this distance. Let's label this distance as VE. So I hope now all the terms are clear. V is image ka distance from eyepiece. U is object ka distance from eyepiece. UE. Hai na? VO, image ka distance from objective. UO, object ka distance from objective. Yeah, I hope that's clear. So beta from this diagram. Ek to beta negative hai. To magnitude of beta. Nikalne ke liye, I will say that's going to be minus beta. Just to make it positive. Now beta is negative, so just to make it positive, I will take minus beta, and now this has become positive. Minus beta mod bhi bol, to jo log mod bol rahe, please understand ki mod is a, you're right, but mod is not a simple function. Mod is a function which does two things. Mod is a function which leaves beta as it is if beta is greater than zero, and it's a function which puts a minus sign when beta is negative, when beta is less than zero. Hai na? So mod function kar kya aa raha hai? Positive numbers ko waisa ka waisa rakh raha hai, negative numbers ko ek minus sign se multiply kar raha hai. To jahan pe hume already pata hai ki ye negative hai, we can do the job of that mod function and we can straight away put a minus sign. Theek hai? Got it? Haan, so to make it positive, beta khud negative tha. To make the negative number positive, hum ek minus sign dal rahe. Alright, now, beta is approximately tan beta. And tan beta, tan of the angle, tan of this angle is going to be how much? It's going to be h double dash. Tan of beta is going to be beta. But now tan of this angle is going to be how much? H double dash by VE. H double dash by VE. So minus beta is going to be H double dash by VE. Minus beta ko positive kiya kyu? Because yahan pe these are sides. Hai na? Sides positive hai. Dono ka ratio bhi positive hoga. These are all lengths. H double dash and V are lengths. They are going to be positive. So I had to make this guy positive as well. So minus beta is H double dash by VE. H double dash by VE can also be written as H dash by UE. Can you see that they're both the same? H double dash by VE yeah, H dash by UE are exactly the same. We can say one more thing from this triangle. Look at this. These two angles are the same. So because these two angles are the same, you can say ki H by UO is H dash by VO. Can you see that? Similar triangles. Height by distance ka ratio same hai. So H by UO is H dash by VO. H by UO is H dash by VO. Okay. What is this supposed to be? I don't know. H by UO is H dash by VO. So maybe I'll squeeze this over to the next side. Or maybe I'll just keep it here itself. H by UO is H dash by VO. I'll explain again. Ye kahan se aaya? This comes from दिस ट्रायंगल, ये देखो कैन यू सी दिस ट्रायंगल, दिस वन एंड दिस वन, ये ट्रायंगल से कैन यू सी कि एच बाय यू ओ इज एच डैश बाय वी ओ, ठीक है, h by u o is h dash by v o. Okay, so that those are our two equations. Ab isse dekho answer kya aata hai, the answer comes out to be something interesting. Let's just write the answer on the other page. Beta is minus h dash by u e, to wo copy kar leta hu. And दूसरी दूसरा चीज क्या देखा हमने यहाँ पे, एच बाई यू नॉट इज एच डैश बाई वी ई, वो भी कॉपी कर रहा हूं, एच बाई यू नॉट इज एच डैश बाई वी ई, एच बाई यू नॉट इज एच डैश बाई वी ई, एच बाई यू नॉट इज एच डैश बाई वी ई, ठीक है. सो लुक इट वॉट एच डैश बिकम्स, एच डैश बिकम्स h v e by u o. When I substitute this guy over here, yeah, I'll write the page number, don't worry. Beta becomes minus h dash, sorry, h dash ko substitute kara, becomes minus h by u o v e by u e, minus h by u o v e by u e, dikh raha hai. ठीक है, आई जस्ट सॉल्व दोस टू इक्वेशंस, एक जगह से एच डैश उठा के दूसरे इक्वेशन में डाल दिया, इतना ही हमने किया. ये करने के बाद देखो अपना मैग्निफिकेशन कितना आ रहा है, तो मैग्निफिकेशन इज बीटा बाय अल्फा, सो इट इज माइनस वी ई बाय यू ई एच बाय यू ओ. रिमेंबर अल्फा इज ऑलवेज द सेम, डजंट डिपेंड ऑन व्हाट इंस्ट्रूमेंट यू आर यूजिंग, अल्फा इज ऑलवेज एच बाय डी. Now, H and H cancel out. And look at what is the result that we are getting. This is quite interesting. Magnification is minus VE by UE. Ek minute. Thoda, let me just cross check. Sorry, let me just cross check what I've done. ये मैंने गलत लिखा, माय बैड, सॉरी. दीज टर्म्स आर लिल इरिटेटिंग. यहाँ पे वापस देख लो, ये गलत बोला, एच बाई यू ओ इज एच डैश बाई वी ओ, ठीक है, एच डैश बाई वी ओ लिखा मैंने, एक्चुअली वी ई लिखा है, वो गलत है, एच बाई यू ओ इज एच डैश बाई वी ओ, ठीक है. So h by u is h dash by v o. Yeah, that makes sense. Now when I substitute this over there, yeah, I'll just need to change this h dash by v o instead of v e. So this is v o. Therefore, when I substitute this h dash in this equation, this becomes minus h by, I'm going to write e on this side. This was also o. और ये भी गलत था, सो दिस इज यू ओ वी ओ यू ई, ठीक है, यू ओ वी ओ यू ई, ठीक है. यहां पे भी आई विल जस्ट मेक द सेम चेंजेस, यू ओ वी ओ एंड यू ई, और फिर फाइनल रिजल्ट क्या आता है देख लो. फाइनल रिजल्ट आता है माइनस वी नॉट बाय यू नॉट, minus v naught by u naught into d by u e. And this is interesting because if you think about this, v naught by u naught is the magnification that you would expect for the objective. क्योंकि लेंस का मैग्निफिकेशन क्या होता है, माइनस वी बाई यू ही तो होता है ना, तो वी नॉट बाई यू नॉट इज द मैग्निफिकेशन यू एक्सपेक्ट फॉर द ऑब्जेक्टिव, एंड डी बाई यू ई इज द मैग्निफिकेशन यू वुड एक्सपेक्ट फॉर द आई पीस. सो यू कैन रिमेंबर दिस रिजल्ट इन दिस वे, एम इज माइनस वी नॉट बाई यू नॉट, सॉरी एम इज मैग्निफिकेशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव इन टू मैग्निफिकेशन ऑफ द आई पीस, मैग्निफिकेशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव इन टू मैग्निफिकेशन ऑफ द आई पीस. आई पीस का मैग्निफिकेशन वही है जो हमने सिंपल माइक्रोस्कोप के वक्त देखा था. द आई पीस इज बिहेविंग एज अ सिंपल माइक्रोस्कोप, यू कैन चेक द डायग्राम अगेन. द आई पीस इज जस्ट डूइंग द जॉब ऑफ अ सिंपल माइक्रोस्कोप. आई पीस के लिए ऑब्जेक्ट सामने बन गया, एक वर्चुअल इमेज बना रहा है. वेर एज योर ऑब्जेक्टिव इज बिहेविंग एज अ लेंस. सो वाई डू आई से दिस इज दिस एम ई, तो सिंपल माइक्रोस्कोप की तरह रिजल्ट आ रहा है. एंड एम ओ, ये तो सिंपल माइक्रोस्कोप की तरह इसका रिजल्ट आ रहा है. एम ओ में माइनस साइन क्यों आ रहा है इज योर क्वेश्चन. तो माइनस साइन आएगा ना व्हेन यू सब्स्टिट्यूट डिस्टेंसेस. एम ओ इज वी बाई यू, बट नाउ इमेज का कोऑर्डिनेट्स इज पॉजिटिव वी नॉट, ऑब्जेक्ट का कोऑर्डिनेट्स इज नेगेटिव यू नॉट. सो व्हेन यू सब्स्टिट्यूट इट इन टर्म्स ऑफ द डिस्टेंसेस यू विल गेट टू सी द माइनस साइन, एंड वी नॉट एंड यू नॉट आर पॉजिटिव टेलिंग यू एम ओ इज नेगेटिव. And you can see in the diagram as well, MO, the objective is inverting the image. The objective is inverting the image. Samajh mein aaya? Finally, ye result yaad karne ke liye kaafi easy ho gaya. Yaad kya hai? Jo simple microscope wala part hai, usko waise hi rakho. I'll explain the last part again. Okay, I'll explain the last part again. VO and UO are distances. VO and UO are image distances and object distances. VO and UO are positive. Okay, VO, UO are positive. They are distances. They are greater than zero. They are image and object distances. So, therefore, they are positive. What has happened is, I just said ki this result which we derived is magnification of the eyepiece into magnification of the object. Do lens hai, dono ka magnification multiply ho raha hai, waisa result aa raha hai coincidentally. Ab magnification of the eyepiece kya hai? D into UE. Yeah? Why? Because the eyepiece behaves like a simple microscope, which we just saw. सिंपल माइक्रोस्कोप का क्या होता है, डी अपॉन ऑब्जेक्ट का डिस्टेंस. यहाँ पे आई पीस में जस्ट टू रिमाइंड यू व्हाट ऑन अर्थ इज यूवी, लुक फॉर द आई पीस. आई पीस के लिए फाइनली तुम्हारा व्हाट बिहेव्स एज द ऑब्जेक्ट फॉर द आई पीस इज एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ यूवी. सो डी अपॉन यूवी मेक्स सेंस फॉर द मैग्निफिकेशन ऑफ द आई पीस. एज फॉर द ऑब्जेक्ट, एज फॉर द ऑब्जेक्टिव, उसका मैग्निफिकेशन तो लेंस का फॉर्मूला डाल दो. लेंस का फॉर्मूला इज वी अपॉन यू, है ना. बट नाउ वी एंड यू आर कोऑर्डिनेट्स, फॉर्मूला में तुम्हें कोऑर्डिनेट्स डालना है. इमेज का डिस्टेंस वी नॉट है, इमेज का कोऑर्डिनेट पॉजिटिव है तो वी नॉट ही डाल दो. ऑब्जेक्ट का डिस्टेंस यू नॉट पॉजिटिव है बट ऑब्जेक्ट का कोऑर्डिनेट नेगेटिव है तो आई हैव टू सब्स्टिट्यूट माइनस यू नॉट. दैट्स वेयर यू गेट अ माइनस साइन. एंड दिस मेक्स सेंस बिकॉज व्हेन यू लुक एट द डायग्राम यू रियलाइज कि इट इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव व्हिच इज एक्चुअली इनवर्टिंग द इमेज. इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव व्हिच इज एक्चुअली इनवर्टिंग द इमेज. Got it? Yeah, so this is the derivation of these derivations do take time. But ultimately the result is something that you can easily remember. Okay. Now, let's see what to do with this. Can I please give a full view of the previous slide? Make look. Okay. Now, typically when you get questions, अब ये याद करो, ये mains के level का है. Mains के level में if they want to ask you a question, they'll give you information to find V0, U0, UE. But now, typically what they expect is, they'll expect you to use some approximations. So now the approximation is such ki, because the object is very close to F0, you will take U0 to be approximately F0, as the object is very close to the focus of the objective. Okay. So U0 will be approximately taken as F0. The other thing you'll do is, you will say that the length of your microscope and the distance between the objective and the eyepiece. If you look at the diagram again, you'll find key the length is it's not infinite. V0 however is pretty large. Can you say that your length is VO plus UE? Length is VO plus UE. So length is VO plus UE, to be very exact. To be very technical, length is VO plus UE. But now an approximation that you'll make is that because length of the microscope, length of the tube of the microscope, length means distance between, this is distance between the objective and the eyepiece. That is V0 plus UE, as you can see in that diagram. Length of the microscope, distance between objective and eyepiece, that is V0 plus UE. So length is V0 plus UE, and because object is very close to the focus, V0 is going to be large. So because V0 is large, what will happen is you will ignore UE in front of V0. And therefore, you will say ki length is approximately V0, because V0 is quite large in comparison to UE. It's not infinite because object exact focus pe dala hi nahi hai, thoda aage dala hi hai. But approximately object ka distance F0 le sakte hai, and image ka distance, tube ka length V0 plus UE ke jagah V0 le sakte hai, because UE is going to be small in comparison to V0. Okay, given that, now what does our magnification become? So now your magnification becomes minus L by F0 Q. Just see that formula again. Magnification kitna tha? V0 by U0 D by UE. The magnification jo tha minus V0 by U0, V0 ko likha L, U0 ko likha F0. So magnification becomes approximately length upon F0 D upon UE. Length upon F0 D upon UE. And that is your magnification. And more important results are your magnification in the two extreme cases. So one case is when your image is formed at infinity, when your eye is least strained. Is case mein, what do you expect the answer to be? L by F0 ko waise hi rakhna hai, UE ko kya kare? What does the second term become when image is formed at infinity? F. And F kiska? Which is behaving as our simple magnifying glass, the eyepiece. Very nice. So this is going to be D by F of eyepiece. So this is your minimum magnification. This is your normal adjustment. Yeah, no problem. Good job. This is your normal adjustment. This is when the eyes are least strained. You always remember, you can see the stars easily. So your eyes are least strained. Normal adjustment. On the other hand, when your eyes are most strained, the arrow dalna padega. This is normal adjustment. When your eyes are most strained, what will this equation become? L by F naught ko as it is rakh lo. What do those two become? What does that second term become? Yes, very nice. So it becomes 1 plus D by FE. 1 plus D by FE. All right. So from a practical point of view, to a person who has made the microscope, these last two formulas are the important formulas. Okay. Why? Because ultimately, you can say ki my magnification varies from this minimum value to this value. Moreover, these are all things which you can know beforehand. You can measure the length of the microscope. You can know the focal length of the objective and the eyepiece, and D ka value pata hi hai sabko. You know, you obviously won't be able to see this. You won't be able to see this. So from a practical point of view, that first formula is useless. Mains agar formula, wo pehla formula test karega, so they'll have to give you the value of UE. And tab waisa test kar sakte hai. Ki somewhere inside the microscope, image IP se itna distance pe ban raha hai. They'll have to say all of that. But the more practically usable formulas for a compound microscope are these two. You have the length, you have both focal lengths, you know the value of D. You can find the range of your magnification. You can find the range of your magnification. Got it? And the minus sign is just to tell us, ki an inverted image is formed. The minus sign is to tell us that an inverted image is formed. So those last two formulas are basically what you need the most. Can we try an example? So let's say page 199. Let's say you have a simple microscope, a compound microscope of length now. The engineer who's making this, he is more concerned with things that are observable. So compound microscope ka length can be known beforehand. So let's say its length is 1 meter. Let's say focal length of the objective is 5 centimeters. And let's say focal length of the eyepiece is 10 centimeters. And baki, you know everything. So find the range. Of the magnification of the compound microscope. Notice, L is in meters. Just give me a minute. नहीं अभी शायद सिर्फ श्रेया का सही आया. एल का वैल्यू चेक कर लो. एल इज इन मीटर्स. एफ ओ एफ ई कैफली. श्रेया का सही आया. सानिका का सही आया. साहिल मैग्निफिकेशन इज द वे इट इज डिफाइंड. So for this lens, for in the world of optical instruments, magnification is defined as beta by alpha, which we established in the beginning of this lecture. So it's not typically height by height, जो हमने ray optics के वक्त देखा था. This is angle by angle, you know, the way we defined in the beginning. Yeah, guys, the answer is, I'm getting all sorts of answers, but the answer I'm getting is minus 50 to minus 70. M lies between minus 70 and minus 50. M lies between minus 70 and minus 50. चेक करें या नो प्रॉब्लम. सही है. गॉट दैट. गुड वन. एम इज माइनस एल बाय एफ नॉट डी बाय एफ ई. माइनस एल बाय एफ नॉट डी बाय एफ ई. So just convert everything in centimeters so that the units cancel out. So minus 100 centimeters by 5 centimeters into, by the way, this is what? This is the minimum magnification. Yeah, minimum magnification itna hai. Into D by FE. D by FE will be 25 centimeters upon 10 centimeters. So this is going to be 100 by 5, 20 into 2.5. 20 into 2.5 is minus 50. No problem. That's all right. Yeah, you'll have sufficient time later to, of course, memorize the formulas and then you won't make these mistakes. Did my screen get stuck? It looks like it got stuck. You don't need to take sine distances because these are all just distances. L is length. Things are all taken care of. Now you just have to substitute. L is length. FO, FE are focal lengths. D is 25 centimeters. Jada kuch sochna nahi hai. Directly dalna hai. Theek hai? F naught, U naught, V naught. These were all distances. Theek hai? We took care of it. We in the lens formula, we applied it carefully. For our convenience, we finally are going to work with just distances. So magnification, when image is formed at near point is minus 50x. Magnification when image is formed at infinity is minus L by F naught, 1 plus D by FE. Matlab ye jo 2.5 aa raha tha, second term, 2.5 ko 1 se bada lo. So it's going to be minus 20 into 3.5, which is going to be minus 70x. So therefore, your magnification lies between. I ka ulta label kiya. Magnification lies between 50 and 70. Jo bada value aata hai, that is when your eye is more strained. So this is D, and jo chota value aata hai, that is when your I is less strained. So this is M infinity. This is the normal adjustment one. The smaller answer is your normal adjustment one. Let me check if I've written that correctly over here. Yeah, pe sahi nikla. Alright. So magnification lies between minus 70 and minus 50. See? Guys, don't confuse this magnification. Just reading one of your doubts. Don't confuse this magnification with the magnification defined for ray optics. Magnification defined for ray optics was height of object by height of image. In the world of optical instruments, magnification has been defined in a different way. You need to understand that difference. Wohi difference humne starting mein explain kiya. What is magnification in this world defined as? What is it defined as? Alpha by, yeah, rather beta by alpha. What does that mean? It's the angle subtended by the image on the eye when you use the instrument upon the angle subtended by the object on the eye without using the instrument. It was very different from the magnification you've learned in ray optics. Ray optics mein HO by HI tha. Ek object ka size, ek image ka size, and there was no question of angle, and there was no question of using the lens and not using the lens. Optical instruments ke liye, we are comparing angle subtended by the image on the eye with the angle that the object could have subtended without the instrument. So that is the difference. See? I'm not giving them any separate names. Ray optics may be magnification ko magnification bolenge. Optical instruments ke case mein bhi isko magnification hi bolenge. But with the context, you can understand when you're working with optical instruments, what magnification means. Got it? Yahan pe jo formula aaya tha, ye coincidence wala formula hai. This comes by coincidence ki jo ye optical instrument ka magnification hai, aur ye jo optical instrument ka magnification hai, uska that is equal to, or that involves magnification of this lens. So yahan pe hum optical instrument ka magnification use kar rahe the, yahan pe lens ka use kar rahe the. This came just by coincidence. Okay, you don't expect two random lenses kept at some random distance to see their magnifications get multiplied in this manner. Okay. Got this? What other doubt? So there are how many total lessons only for mains, and are they easier? Mains has your entire JEE Advanced syllabus plus some 6-7 extra chapters. Most of those extra chapters are done towards the end. This is one of those chapters which I think it makes sense to finish off now, since we have been allotted so much time with ray optics. We'll finish it off now. Mains chapters are comparatively more easy. There isn't much depth, but you'll have to take the effort to learn it. You know, if you don't read at all, you won't be able to solve. And sometimes a good chunk of questions comes from these extra chapters. Arey, tum jo advance mein karoge, wohi ek hi baat hai, yaar. One of you saying we should have taken mains then. See, honestly, the preparation process is the same. You advance guys are going to write mains. You are going to, even in your practice test, you're going to give mains ke tests. Syllabus is all exactly the same. There are a handful of small, when I said 5 to 7 chapters, I meant small chapters. Don't visualize chapters of the size of kinematics and ray optics. Small chapters. Yeah, there are a handful of small chapters. Bas wo extra hai. Your way, the way you prepare for mains is the same as you prepare for advance. Advance mein thoda, of course, depth mein jana padta hai. That's there. But you go in depth to do well in the advanced exam. Not necessarily the mains exam. And again, it only makes sense to go in depth as long as your conceptual understanding is increasing. You don't just solve tough questions for the sake of it. Tough questions help you understand the concepts properly. And once you understand concepts properly, you can solve easy questions. You can solve tough questions all the same. Yeah, that's the idea. Do I have time to start a telescope? Maybe we can just try to make the diagram and see. Yeah, let's see how much time I have. So, telescopes. In telescopes, you have this one telescope called as an astronomical telescope. Yes, Ayush, I'll share it. एक बार क्लास के बाद वापस पूछ लें. Okay, so the telescope that we are going to consider actually is an astronomical telescope. Okay, your HCV has mentioned something called as a terrestrial telescope. उस सब का जरूरत नहीं है. The telescope we'll consider is an astronomical telescope. Okay, so now your astronomical telescope involves two lenses. So the first lens, this is your eyepiece. Actually, telescope ke world mein hi, before I draw the diagram, telescope ke world mein hi, we'll need to redefine the magnification just once more, you know? So magnification, just to understand how it works, it's again angle subtended by the image. It's angle subtended by the image while using the instrument. While using the instrument, divided by angle subtended by the image. Without using the instrument, or I can say angle subtended by the image bolne ke jagah object, angle subtended by the object to the unaided eye, angle subtended by the object without using the instrument. So angle subtended by the object to the unaided eye. And you need to understand ki this can also, you can also say this term is the same as angle subtended unaided means without the objective, without the instrument. Unaided means without the instrument. So you can also say this is the angle subtended on the instrument. You can also say this is the angle subtended by the object on the instrument, because let me just explain that. If my instrument looks like this, see, let's say my instrument has some lens and then I place my eye over here. Let's say this is my telescope. Again, if my far off object is going to subtend some angle on the telescope, it subtends more or less the same angle on the eye, because this distance is negligible in comparison to the distance of the object. So angle subtended on the telescope and angle subtended on the eye both are roughly the same. Because in comparison to how far the object is, this distance is negligible. Samajh mein aaya? All right, so this angle, remember, this is what we call as beta divided by alpha. So the angle that the object subtends on the telescope is also the angle that it subtends on the eye. Why? Because this distance is small in comparison to how far the object is. Understood that point? L is small in comparison to the object's distance. Okay, I'll explain the diagram again. See, so the definition was ki magnification is angle that the image subtends on the eye upon with the instrument upon angle object subtends on the eye without the instrument, which was kind of the definition for microscopes as well. Now I'm just drawing your eyes to, I'm drawing your attention to this point, ki the angle subtended on the unaided eye will be roughly the same as the angle subtended at this end of the instrument. Your eye will be on this end. I will be near the eyepiece, and the angle subtended on the objective will be more or less the same. Why is it more or less the same? Because the object is so far away that these lines, the distance in comparison to the object's distance is negligible. This distance in comparison to the object's distance is negligible. So those angles will more or less be the same. जैसे तुम एकदम zoom out करोगे ना, यहाँ पे तुम्हारा moon और यहाँ पे तुम्हारा छोटा सा telescope, है ना? So don't you agree कि your moon is going to more or less subtend the same angle at both ends of the telescope? Doesn't make sense? मून जो आंख पे सबटेंड करता था उतना ही टेलीस्कोप पे सबटेंड कर रहा है, बिकॉज़ द टेलीस्कोप इज सो टाइनी इन कंपैरिजन टू द डिस्टेंस ऑफ द मून. यस, यू कैन कंसीडर दैट द मून इज एट इंफिनिटी. वैसे वो लेने का मोर लेस एट इंफिनिटी ले सकते हो. यस, कैन कंसीडर दैट द ऑब्जेक्ट इज एट इंफिनिटी कंपेयर टू द फोकल लेंस ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड द लेंस. सो द मून इज फार फार अवे. The telescope is as good as a point. And because the telescope is as good as a point in comparison to the moon, these angles, alpha over here and alpha over there, are going to be the same. Make sense? ये मैंने जो पिछला डायग्राम ड्रॉ किया ना वो काफी थोड़ा सा मिसलीडिंग है. ये जो नीचे ड्रॉ किया, that's a more accurate depiction. Your telescope is going to be, in fact, even tinier than this. Can we see the sun from a telescope? Yaar, we couldn't. I mean, I wouldn't want to do that. I think the intensity of light that is going to be converged when you use a telescope to see the sun is going to be too intense. I think it would even damage your eyes in that sense. I'm sure there may be some ways to photograph that telescope. Image of the sun. See? So one of you saying, never use a telescope to observe a star. Ye maine suna nahi hai. Would that also be dangerous? Achha. It's apparently a caution given on the box. So you'd expect ki objects emitting light of high intensity, if you are going to use a lens to try to look at that, it's going to naturally focus all that intensity onto your eye, and that could even damage your eye. Okay. Haan, the sun mostly, usko dekhne mein difficulty hoga. We'll stop over here. We'll of course continue in the next class. Jada bacha nahi hai. This telescope wala part chota hai. Let's just end things over here. just remember ki we'll continue from this point. Jo angle objective pe subtend hota hai, wohi alpha hai. So in the telescope diagrams, hume alpha aur beta ek saath dikhega. Rugve, that's a good idea. Yes, that could be done. That's a good idea. Kya New Year party? I'm with my family. I'm just going to celebrate with them. Tomorrow I may go on a trip somewhere. Most probably near Pavna Lake. Happy New Year to all of you guys. Enjoy your long weekend. I hope Saturday, Sunday off hai tumhare liye. Is it Diana? Cool. Are nahi hai kya Saturday, Sunday off? She. Sad. Just tomorrow's an off, okay? Fortunately for me, hai Saturday, Sunday off. So, I have an extended weekend. And that's why I'll be going on a short trip. Yes, Happy New Year to you guys. Have a blessed year ahead. अरे फ्राइडे को छुट्टी देके संडे को रख दिया. दिस इज वेरी अनफेयर. चलो बाय. हैप्पी न्यू ईयर अगेन. ऑल द बेस्ट. बाय. यू वेलकम. बाय. Bye. You're welcome. Enjoy your holiday. Bye. Mm-hmm.